As a pediatric surgeon, I meet babies all the time who have had intestinal loss, mainly from problems of prematurity. And when they lose a significant amount of their intestine, they can no longer eat enough to get enough nutrition to survive. And so tissue engineering is attempting to engineer that tissue that they've lost.
We're at a workshop that CIRM has convened to look at the opportunities in tissue engineering and where engineering strategies might interface with stem cells and stem cell science.
I think of tissue engineering as the replacement or regeneration of human organs and human tissues to restore normal function.
Cartilage, for example, is a very useful application for tissue engineering. If you can devise a material that can allow cells to thrive and provide the mechanical support in that environment, That's tissue engineering.
Tissue engineering is not a new idea. We've been able to replace skin, for example, for a long time using tissue engineering techniques. What is new, however, is the ability to actually put cells into those bits of tissue engineered biomaterials.
A lot of the materials that are currently used by surgeons, if you need to have a hip implant or you need to have a blood vessel replaced, they're based on materials like Gore-Tex or titanium alloys, the same types of things you might find in a golf bag. And so we're interested in trying to design new types of materials that will promote stem cell growth and promote the body's healing process.
This kind of meeting is so important to convene engineers and stem cell biologists and government officials and investors and other key stakeholders to really understand what the challenges are.
And think about the really big problems in the fields. What are sort of the things that are keeping our research from moving forward and being able to move into patients?
We want to ensure in the conversation that we're having here that the scientists are engaging with the patients in mind and help CIRM understand how we can help drive that science forward.
One big roadblock right now is how do we actually deliver stem cells to a patient? When you force the cells through a syringe needle, that can be damaging to the cells. So one of the roadblocks that my group is trying to overcome is design a gel-like material that would encapsulate the cells and kind of provide a soft cushion for them so that they can survive the injection process.
With CIRM funding, we've made a lot of progress, and we've actually been able to work out in some mouse models exactly how to grow the engineered intestine. The hurdles are that we have to understand the science better and actually be able to make the transition to humans.
There are a lot of wonderful ideas here, and we may be able to help some of these researchers move their product from an early experimental stage into maybe even clinical trials. I think with tissue engineering, regenerative medicine, there's actually now the hope that maybe we can cure some of these diseases.